Hello and welcome to Rocket Systems YouTube channel. In the previous video, we discussed how we can install the Jetpack OS image on the external SD card of the WaveShare Jetson Nano. In this video, we are going to see how we can install the SDK components. So in our previous video, while installing the OS image using the SDK manager, we didn't select the SDK components. Now why SDK components is important? So when you have the Jetson Nano developer kit or any kit, so you'll probably want to have all the demos and the samples or the models which the NVIDIA recommends so that you can start your programming work. Now one of the good place to start is their GitHub repository. Now in the GitHub repository, they have mentioned to build the project from the source, but we won't be able to perform all these steps because we do not have the SDK components, and this is why installing the SDK components is very important. So let's get started. Okay, so I'm back into my Jetson device, and there are a few things which we need to perform on our Jetson Nano before we can install SDK components. So we first have to make sure that we are connected to internet, and then we'll simply update the system. So once that is done, we need to make sure that we have installed openssh-server in our Jetson Nano, because from SDK manager, we are going to control the Jetson using SSH. So we can run command. Now I've already installed this, so I'm not going to install it again, but you'll have to perform this command to install the openssh. Once that is done, we have to note down our IP address. So my IP address is 192.168.1.12. Okay, that's all. Okay, so I'm back into my Ubuntu machine, and now I'm going to open SDK manager. Now here you will notice that it's showing us no board connected, which is fine because we have not connected our Jetson Nano. In this, we will keep selecting this and will continue to step 02. Now here we don't have to select the Jetson OS image because this we have already installed in our previous video, and we are just going to select all these options of Jetson SDK components. Now I will click on this, I accept, and then I will continue to step 03. Let's enter the password. Okay, now here it is asking the connection mode for the Jetson Nano. Now, if you want, you can still connect the Jetson Nano using the USB, but because we have installed the SSH, so I'm going to select the option of Ethernet. Now here I'm going to enter the IP address of the Jetson Nano. Sorry, it's one. Now I'm going to enter the username and the password. And I'll click install. And you will notice that it is now going to install all these SDK components, and once installed, then it's going to connect to my Jetson Nano and it will start the installation process. So it can take some time depending upon the internet speed, so we'll resume once it is all complete. Okay, so all the Jetson SDK components are now successfully installed on our Jetson Nano, and now we can begin to build the project of Jetson inference in our Jetson Nano. So we'll cover that in our next video, but for this video there is just one thing which I want to show you. So let me just quickly SSH into my Jetson device. Okay, now if I do df-sh to check the space, so you will notice that, so this is our main storage device, this is our external SD card, and you will notice that all the components which we have installed are now installed on our external storage size. As you can see, the size has increased, while on the other side, if you'll notice, the internal storage is still as it is. So the motive of this video is just to make sure that now our external SD card is being used as our primary storage instead of our internal storage. So I guess that's all for this video. In the next video, we will install the Jetson Inference Hello AI project from source. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe.